अन्धे वांछित लाभाय कर्म किं तन्न कथ्यते किं दंपतिमिति ब्रूयाम उदाहो दंपति इति. We finished with the gadyam where Durvasa came and gave a garland and Indra pashyata eva maharshehe anupaniya makutatatim anagraya cha antataha skanda eva sindurasya niveshayamasa without even smelling it nor without first he did not honor it, so anupaniya makutatatim. Next he did not even acknowledge it by at least smelling it. You don't need to give honor, you should at least acknowledge it. He completely ignored it and just threw it on the elephant. And what did the elephant do? Nisarga niravagrahena. Elephant is after all an animal, that's all. What is it going to know about anything? So it immediately took that garland and crushed it with its trunk. Right? Now the effect of that, what happened? Kamakshila Raghavi Aradha Tarpadikrila. Next to the our 4-5 shlokas are there. So one
okay, Mati Mati Vanapadikrila.
Yes.
Mati Mati Vanapadikrila. Okay. Kalika Parada. Pashyan Padagra Mriditam Mahata Gajena Malam Prasada Paripaka Mayim Mridanyaha हस्तेन हस्तम अभिहत्य स नित्यकोपः कोपारुणं मुनिरत् मुनिः अधारयत् अक्षिकोणं.
सो पश्यन् पदाग्रमृदितां, द मीटर इज सच दैट इट हैज टू बी पदाग्रमृदितां. சரியா? அதனால பாத பத போத் ஆர் தி சேம். சோ பஷ்யன் பதாக்ரமிருதிதாம் மகதா கஜேன, மகதா கஜேன பதாக்ரமிருதிதாம் மாலாம் பஷ்யன். Seeing the garland being crushed by the great elephant, mahata gajena, by the great elephant, padagra mriditam malam pashyan. What is that mala? Mridanyaha prasada paripaka mayim malam pashyan. Mridanyaha, mridani is mridasya patni, mridaha is Shiva, and mridani is Parvati. Mridanyaha, it is a prasadam from Parvati, right? She said that kayapi vidyadharya sorry the mundina paragraph la irukume he gave that elephant that kayapi enga irukudhu kanaka aravindamayim amlana malikam anayanta prarthana matrena vidya gauri prasada samasaditam. That's what I was searching for. Gauri prasada samasaditam. Gauri, it is a prasada or a grace of Gauri Parvati. So here he uses the word mridani. Mridanyaha prasada paripakamayim. Paripaka parinama, parinamamayim. Her grace, it is like a transformation of Parvati's grace, or prasada is happiness. Two meanings for that. Prasada means anugraha and prasada means sukham, happiness. So the more she was very pleased with the devotion shown by the Vidyadhari, and so her happiness was transformed into the form of this mala. Prasada paripakamayim malam kasyaha prasadam mridanyaha parvatyaha tam malam padagra mriditam pashyan. Seeing that it was being crushed by its foot, right? He does not say that it he pressed it with its foot, right? Vedandena shundaya akrishya nishpipishe, he just crushed it. Now here we know that it is padagra mriditam. The elephant just crushed it with his foot. Seeing that, what happened to the sage? Munihi koparunam akshikonam adharayat. The sage had the corner of his eye became red. Akshi konam koparunam adharayate. It became red because of kopa, anger. What did he do? Nitya kopaha saha munihi. It's very easy to make him angry. So nitya kopaha, he is always angry because he is the avatara of Shiva's anger, which came as Anasuya's garbha. Right, so he is not just a mere avataram of Shiva. He is actually the Shiva's anger's avataram. That's why Nitya Kopaha Saha Munihi Koparanam Akshikonam Adharayat Katham Hastena Hastam Abhihatya. If you have seen all these old movies, you will see the villain doing this. No? Immediately, as soon as some angry situation is there, he will clap with his hand, right? So that's what he did. Hastena Hastam Abhihatya. He hit one hand, clapped one hand with the other, and then he possessed an eye which was angry, which was red with anger. Okay, you should imagine that scene. The moment he saw the garland being crushed by that elephant, he became very angry. He first clapped one hand with the other hand, and his eyes became red. Pashyan padagra mrititam mahatagajena malam prasada paripaka mayim vridanyaha. Here the Uddipana Vibhava is that padagra mrititam malam pashyan. Uddipana Vibhava is that which increases the sentiment, the anger sentiment here. Right? That is the mala. The crushing of that mala is the Uddipanam here. So pashyan padagra mrititam mahata gajena malam prasada paripaka mayim mridanyaha hastena hastam abhihatya sanitya kopaha koparunam munihi adharayat akshikonam. Next.
Hastena hastam abhihatya, then adu vandu vyabhicharya.
Anubhavam. Yeah. That is the Anubhava. Vyabhichari Bhava is the
Akshikona.
So this is actually Bhavam. Anaka Bhava called Preya Alankara. Rasavat Alankaram. Bhavam inge theriyirathu. It is not the Krodha that is the Alankara here. It is the Bhava that is the Alankara. So it is Preya Alankara. Next. Raghavi padikriya. Hello. Read the next shloka. It's a very simple one.
इंद्रस्य अज्ञता वीरभद्रैव कृत्ये वीरमाहेश्वरे मुरम् इति कर्तव्यता मूढम् इन्द्रम् ऐक्षन्त देवताः.
इति कर्तव्यता मूढम् इन्द्रम् देवताः ऐक्षत. ఎప్పో ఐ మీన్ అట్ వాట్ టైమ్ వీరభద్రైవ కృద్దే వీరమాహేశ్వరే మునౌ. వెన్ ముని, వెన్ దట్ దుర్వాస, వీరమాహేశ్వరే మునౌ, వెన్ దట్ దుర్వాస హూ ఇస్ లైక్ వీర శైవః. You know, you talk of people who are Veera Vaishnava, Veera Shaiva. This is exactly what it is. So Veera Maheshwara, in the sense, he is such a great follower of Shiva, that Muni. So he became angry like Veerabhadra. Veerabhadra, during Sati episode, if you remember, as soon as Sati gave up her body, Shiva took a lock of his hair and broke it into two. Only from that, Veerabhadra came and Kali also came. So one portion became Veerabhadra and the other portion became Kali. So Veerabhadra is supposed to be an amsha of Shiva. So he became angry like Veerabhadra. Why? Because that Durvasa is also Veera Maheshwara. He is a Shaivite. And he has the essence of Shiva in him. So Veera Maheshwara Munau Veeraha Cha Maheshwaraha Shivasya Shishyaha or Shivasya Avataraha Maheshwaraha. So Veera Maheshwara Munau Sati Veerabhadra Iva Krudhe Sati. When he was angry like Veerabhadra, that is an Upama Alankara there. Devatas who were surrounding there, they saw Indra in a very helpless state. He didn't know what to do at that point of time. Iti kartavyata moodaha. Kim kartavyam iti tatra moodaha abhavate saha. Iti kartavyam. Iti kartavyam, this is what has to be done. So in that manner or in that attitude, what has to be done, in that attitude, he became a moodha or a fool. He did not know what to do. That's what it means. So iti kartavyata moodham indram aikshanta. Isn't he was totally, when the garland was crushed by the elephant, and when the sage became very angry, that is, one could feel like, because if it is, he became angry like Veerabhadra, then one can feel that anger immediately. But at that point of time, Indra became just like a stambha. He did not know what to do. Iti karatavyata moodham indram aikshanta devaha. Okay, yeah?
Here, for iti kartavyata moodaha, tatra vigrahavakyam kim bhavati mahode?
Iti kartavyam. इति कर्तव्यतायाः भावः इति कर्तव्यता इति कर्तव्यतायां यः मूढः सः
ओ सप्तमी
सो इति कर्तव्यतायां मूढः सप्तमी तत्पुरुषम्
ओके
सो इन् दि एटिट्यूड् आफ् वाट् टु डू हि बिकेम् अ फूल्
ओके नाट् इति कर्तव्यतया मूढः
इति कर्तव्यतया मूढः नो 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 विच् मीन्स् हौ विल् इट् बि In the, no, it is Vishaya Saptami. Because it is, see, you have changed it into Iti Kartavyasya Bhavaha Iti Kartavyata. Right? Mm. So in that Bhava, he became a fool. It is not because of that he became a fool. If you say because of what to do, it won't make sense, right?
Oh, yeah.
It's yeah. only Vishaya Saptami. That is in bhakti bhakti shreshtaha, not bhaktya shreshtaha. It is bhaktau bhakti bhave shreshtaha, bhakti vishaye shreshtaha. So bhaktau shreshtaha.
Oh, astu avagatam.
Right. So iti kartavyata moodham indram devataha ikshanta desahe. Okay, so veera maheshware munau iti kartavyata moodham indram ikshanta devaha. Next one so,
iti kartavyata and kim kartavyata adeda
adeda
okay maybe I missed
kim kartavyam iti kartavyam it's all the same so you can say kim kartavyata moodaha is also see kim karahan varche kim karomi iti yaha prichhati saha kim karaha that is a servant
oh indran okay indran
Next one is the way the kopam, he describes the anger of Durvasa.
Neha kopaha, yavat santvayitum tad antika bhuvam dhavanti mandi bhavat kaku vyakula gadgada stuti vacho gumpha nilimpaha swayam tavat devapatim shashapa kutila krura bhramat taraka bhubhanga vyatishanga datta bhuvanatankaha munihi shankaraha.
Shankaraha Munihi, Shankaraha Munihi Devapatim Shashapa. That's your main sentence here. So, Yavat Devataha, Yavat Nilimpaha, Santvayitum Tadantika Bhuvam Dhavanti, Tavat Munihi, Shankaraha Munihi Devapatim Shashapa. That's your main sentence here. So, Yavat, as and when the Devas ran towards the sage, to, you know, sort of appease him, santvayitum, when they tried to go and tried to appease him, at that point of time, the sage, Devapatim Shashapa, cursed Indra. Now, what are all the adjectives? We have to come and connect it there. So, yavat, as the devas, nilimpaha, nilimpaha are the devas. The vikra, the... Vyutpati is a very weird Vyutpati. I don't know how to get it, so I just took it like that. So, Nilimpaha are Devaha. Swayam Dhavanti. Swayam Tadantikam Dhavanti. Santvayitum Dhavanti. As they were, they themselves ran towards the sage. How did they do that? The adjective for Nilimpaha, for the Devaha, is the entire word from Mandi, Bhavati, Kaku, Vyakula, Gadgada, Stuti, Vacho, Gumpaha. So because they saw Indra completely helpless and he was not at all moving, they decided that they had to do something, and so they quickly started saying stuti vakya. They were praising him with high pitched cries and all that, and they wanted to go and appease the sage. As they were trying to move, within that small slip of time, Durvasa cursed him, right? So what is the adjective? Mandi bhavat kaku vyakula gadgada stuti vacho gumpaha. Gumpaha, they were trying to string words together in order to praise him. So stuti vacho gumpaha, stuti vachasam, stuti vachamsi gumpanti. The gumpanam is actually todukkardu, you know, like how you string flowers, right? That is gumpanam. So stuti vachaha gumpanti, you have to see, to praise the sage, you have to put the words appropriate in an appropriate manner and try to string it in such a manner that the sage will appreciate it, right? So that is why he uses the word gumpa. The words are all separate here. They are trying to get the words together and string them into a praise so that the sage can understand it. They are not able to say a vakyam quickly, right? So that's why he says vachaha. Words are there and they are trying to put the words together. That is the adjective for the devas here. So stuti vacho gumpaha, those who were trying to string words of praise together. And how are they doing it? Mandi bhavat kaku vyakula gadgada, with cries. Gadgadam is the change of taludalutha korallumbo. Adhaadu, you are very upset or angry, your words change, your pitch changes, right? So vyakula, you are extremely disturbed, and gadgada, trembling voices. And gadgada, trembling, vyakula, confused words. Kaku is high pitched. That is, kaku is the dhvani vikaraha based on bhaya or ashrupatam. Anger or upset or grief will change your voice. It is not your normal voice, right? That is kaku. Here they are very afraid of him. So mandi bhavat, slowly they start. Actually, mandi bhavat in the sense, the voice is normally very gambhiram. That is, it's got a very nice pitch. As it goes up or high pitched because of the fear, it'll become thin, right? That's what he's saying. So mandi bhavat kaku, the high pitched cries are mandi bhavanti. They are going very thin and high pitched voice, which have changed because of the fear. And vyakula, they are very confused. Gadgada, trembling voices of praise, words of praise. They're trying to do that. So the devatas, because they saw the helplessness of Indra, they try to string words of praise with their high pitched voice. And tada santvayitum, in order to appease the sage, they themselves ran towards him. Atad antikabum tat samipe dhavanti yavat, yet samaye te dhavanti tat samaye tavat, within that time. Meanwhile, Shankaraha munihi, another big adjective for Durvasa. How is he? Kutila krura bhramat taraka bhrubhanga vyatishanga datta bhuvana atanka. He gives, datta atankaha, bhuvana atankaha. He gives suffering to the entire world because of his terrible eyes and his eyebrows. His eyebrows are kutila krura bhramat taraka bhrubhanga vyatishanga. His eyes are also, the pupil inside the eye is called tarakam. That taraka bhramat, it is moving, the pupils are moving. And it is also vyatishanga, it is associated with brubanga or the scrunching of the eyebrows. Immediately when you're angry, the first thing that shows is the eye. That's why he started off with munihi koparunam akshikonam adharayat. The moment someone is angry, you don't see it. The face is the first thing that shows, not your mouth or anything else. Only the eye and the eyebrow that will immediately show the anger. That's why he highlights that point here. So Shankaraha Munihi, Kutila is crossed, Krura, cruel or terrible. Bhramat, moving, Taraka, roaming, Taraka is pupils. So with roaming, with the very cruel or terrible and crossed pupils, Vyatishanga along with the Brubanga. Brubanga is the scrunching of the eyebrows. He gives a great suffering to the entire world. So which means the moment he gets angry, the world is going to suffer. That's what we know. Right? So he says the suffering of the world is given because of the scrunching of eyebrows and the angry eyes of Durvasa. Kutila krura bhramat taraka brubanga vyatishanga datta bhuvana atankaha. Atankaha is pida. Bhuvanebhyaha atankaha dattaha. Yena sa munihi. Munihi Shankaraha. I've given the samasa for you here. Okay. Mandi bhavat ka. I have not given for kutila krura. Okay. That you can find out from the vyakhyanam. It is very easy. Huh? Kutile bhramanti tarake brubangayoho vyatishangaha granthihi. I think it is the he uses the vyatishanga for brubanga, that is the scrunching of the eyebrows. That's what he uses. But vyatishanga can also mean saha or sangha, with, along with. In that meaning also you can use that. Okay, so yavat sanpayitum tadantika bhuvam dhavanti mandi bhavat kaku vyakula gadgada stuti vacho gumpha nilimpaha swayam tavad devapatim shashapakutila krura bhramat taraka bhrubhanga vyatishanga datta bhuvanatanko munihi shankaraha. See, the moment the sentiment of anger is up here, see, this is shapa anger, and in the first half, if you see, there is bhaya. Both bhavam are included in this. Both sthayi bhavas are included here. That's the beauty of this poem. Because it is like a reflection. The moment you see anger somewhere, there should be someone who is feeling the fear also. Right? And he has included both. It is called bhava sandhi, where two bhavas are coming together at this point. Bhava shabalata means you don't know, there are many bhavas that are coming together. Whereas if you have just two things coming together, it is called bhava sandhi. Here you have bhaya and krodha coming together. Yavat santvayitum tadantika bhuvam dhavanti mandi bhavat kaku vyakula gadgada stuti vacho gumpha nilimpa swayam tavad devapatim shashapa kutila krura bhramat taraka brubhanga vyatishanka datta bhuvanatanko muni shankaraha. Okay. Now, what is the shapa that he gave? That shapa itself is very simple here. Yayam, can you read it?
Yayam Trailokya Rajashrihi Tvadalambane Alambena Cheshtate Saivadhyat Tvad Amitrana Vashamapadhyatamiti.
Iti Shapaha, Iti Shashapa. That Iti actually has to combine with the earlier shloka where he says Devapatim Shashapa Katham Ya Iyam Trailokya Rajashrihi Tvad Alambane Cheshtate Alambena Cheshtate Tvad Alambane Indrasya Alambena Ya Rajyashrihi Cheshtate. You know that Rajyashri, the kingdom, the wealth of the kingdom which moves because of Indra's support. Tvad Alambane, because of your support, that Rajyashri Cheshtate. Cheshta means it is just even a small thing moves because of Indra's support. Because Indra is the king there and he takes care of everything. He is the Rakshakaha. That is why this Rajyashri moves. That today Saeva Adya. See, this Ya and Sa and all, you have to take the entire Amaravati description here in your mind to understand what it is. See, Trailokya Rajyashrihi. It is the entire wealth of all the three worlds that is there. Everybody wants to go to that Swarga. You saw that description of Amaravati, right? So keep that in mind when you read this. Ya Iyam Trailokya Rajyashrihi त्वदालम्बेन चेष्टते दट् विच् मूव्स् बिकास् आफ् युर् सपोर्ट् तत् त्वदालम्बेन बिकास् आफ् युर् सपोर्ट् इट् मूव्स् सा एव अद्य दट् त्रैलोक्यराज्यश्री अद्य टुडे त्वदमित्राणां वशम् आपद्यताम् लेट् इट् कम् अण्डर् द कण्ट्रोल् आफ् त्वदमित्राणां त्वच्छत्रु त्वच्छत्रूणां वशम् लेट् इट् कम् अण्डर् द कण्ट्रोल् आफ् युर् एनिमीस् ओके इति शशाप द शशाप गोस् फ्रम् द अर्लियर् श्लोक सो एयं त्रैलोक्यराज्यश्रीः त्वदालम्बेन चेष्टते सैवाद्य त्वदमित्राणां वशम् आपद्यताम् इति नेक्स्ट् इमीडियट्लि सी द ग्रेट्नेस् आफ् पीपल् आर् इवन् इन् शाकुन्तलम् यु सी वेन् द दुर्वास gives the shapam that Shakuntala, Dushyanta will forget Shakuntala, immediately as soon as someone comes and falls at his feet, they will amend it. They may not be able to take back the words, but they will amend or they will give an end to the shapa. See here, when he gives the shapam, everything will become under the control of your enemies, right? Then there is no end to it that he has said. So the moment he realizes his mistake and he asks for forgiveness, at that point the muni or the sage will give an anugraha and tell the end of that shapa. That is the next shloka here. Munera anugraha. Alambya?
Padikva? आलम्ब्य दैन्यम् असकृत् पदयोः निपत्य सम्प्रार्थितः भगवता स्तुवता ततः अयं शापान्तमाह कथयन् इव लोकरीत्या गोविन्द एव कुशलानि करिष्यति इति
See the, in contrast, look at the simplicity of the shlokas. You saw that Brahmattaraka, Kutila Krura Brahmattaraka, Bruvanga. Now how he used a huge samasa because he wanted to convey that sentiment. The words have, that's what in Pratapradriyam he will say, right? Shabdaspuranam and Arthaspuranam. The Shabdaspuranam is where the words also reflect the rasa, the sentiment that has to be portrayed. So here it is an anugraham. So he uses small, small words where the samasa is not bhuyastham. There is no long, big samasa here. So, alambya dainyam asakriti padayoho nipatya. Samprarthitaha maghavata. Maghavata samprarthitaha tataha. Tataha ayam munihi maghavata samprarthitaha. Maghavan is indraha. So, stuvata maghavata stotram karishyataha maghavan. Sorry, excuse me. Stuvata Maghavata by Indra, who was praising him, who was saying so many stotras to the sage. What did he do? Dainyam Alambya. See that Dainyam is Dinasya Bhavaha Dainyam. Dinaha is a person who has to be pitied, a very pitiable nature. So he left his pride. In the before, in that paragraph we saw, in that Gadhyam we saw that Pashyata eva Maharshehe saha Sindurasya Niveshayamasa. Yeah, so Pashyata eva, there we saw him ignore him. The moment he saw the anger of Durvasa and the moment he said, you will lose all your wealth. That is when, you know, pride comes before a fall. So he immediately, he fell down from his position and he lost his pride. He left his pride and he was in a very pathetic state at that point of time. So, dainyam alambya. He adopted a very low attitude or a pitiable attitude. And asakrita padayoho nipatya, not once. Sakrit is once. Asakrit is many times. He fell at his feet many times nipatya. Samprarthitaha ayam munihi. Being the sage was being prayed thus by Indra. Prarthitaha ayam munihi. Lokaritya kathayan iva. He, as if to adopt the normal ways of the world, you know, yada yada hi dharmasya glanir bhavati bharata abhyuttanam adharmasya tad atmanam srijamyaham. That is the way of the world. Whenever there is an adharma glani, there is a sorry dharma glanihi. When the dharma goes down, that is when Indra, the Vishnu, takes an avatara. That is the loka riti. So it is as if he is talking about that custom of the world, right? As if adopting the normal ways of the world, as if saying the norm, what happens normally in this world. He says, Govinda eva kushalani karishyati iti shapantam aha. He said the end of the shapa will be, how will it be Govinda eva. See, the word he uses is also very beautiful. Gam vindati, the one who protects the world. Gauhu is also cow. At the same time, Gauhu is also earth. Govindaha does not mean just a cowherd. Gauhu is earth. So the one who protects the earth. How does Vishnu protect the earth? He protects the earth by taking avatara as and when there is an increase in adharma. So Govinda eva kushalani karishyati. Vishnu is the person who has to, who will come and do beneficial things, right? He will do the auspicious things for you. That is the way of the world. As if to say that this is the way of the world, lokaritya kathayan eva, govindaha eva kushalani karishyati, iti shapantamah. Alambya dainyam asakrit padayor nipatya. Samprarthito maghavata stuvata tataha ayam. Shapanta maha kathayanniva lokaritya. That is Utpreksha Alankara there. Lokaritya kathayanna iva. It is as if he was telling them the way of the world. Govinda eva kushalani karishyati iti. Even that Govinda is parikara ankura alankara, where the adjective itself is used with an abhipraya. Sorry, the word that we use, that is the noun itself, is used with an abhipraya. We have talked about parikara ankura alankaram before itself. So Govinda eva kushalani karishyati iti shapantam ah. Next, now the effect of the shapa, he starts off with the gadya. This is a big gadya where the first half is he talks about how Indra loses his enthusiasm. The Nagaram, that is the Amaravati, in contrast, immediately we saw the great Kolahalam that was there with the army and everything that was there. That entire thing became silent now. See, as you can immediately feel the change in the scene with this Gadya. And then the second half of the Gadyam is where the Asuras prepare for war and how they attack Amaravati. So the first half is how the Utsaham immediately comes down in the city and with Indra.
Tadanu yathagatam gate durvasasi tavata vaibhavena vinirgato api tarkitopa atarkita upanata diya shapa samutsaritotsahaha tadiya shapa.
The very unique thing that I have found in Nilakanta Dikshita is he starts off every section of his samasa with a vowel. So it is very difficult to read it when it is just as a sandhi, right?
Yeah.
So everything he starts off with an ah or a oo, something like that. That's why.
Api atarkita upanata tadiya shapa samutsarita utsahaha samagrena mandalena nirjihano raka shashanka iva Rahu Mukhe Patitaha Surapatihi.
We'll stop with that because the next portion is in Dvitiya Vibhakti, and all of that will go to Nagaram. Where is that? Nagaram Agatya. Punar Nagaram Agatya. It will all go as an adjective to that. So till Surapatihi, only this one is the adjective for Surapati, which is in Prathama Vibhakti. Okay, so Tadanu, immediately after that, Durvasasi yatha agatam gate sati. Yatha agatam, just like how he arrived, he left in the same manner. Gate sati, durvasasi, gate sati, as he left, tavata vaibhavena vinirgataha api, atar tavata vaibhavena vinirgataha api, tavata vaibhavam is again purvokta amaravati description, varnana. And the, you know, the he showed when he described Indra, there were two aspects that he showed for Indra's Vaibhavam. Vaibhavam is not just Aishwaryam, not just the money or the wealth or the greatness of Amaravati, not just that wealth. It also showed the Taporupa Vaibhavam that he had because of that, he was praying to Shiva in the Ganga Tiram, right? We saw that also. So both vaibhavam you have to take here. So tavada vaibhavena vinirgataha, even when he had left or started with such a big show of his wealth, both his army, Amaravati Nagaram, and his personal wealth, which is his spirituality, that also he showed off by going to the Ganga Tiram and praying to the Lord. No, he made that linga and everything. So tavata vaibhavena vinirgataha api, even though he started off with such a big show of wealth, atarkita upanata tadiya shapa samutsarita utsahaha, his utsaha, his enthusiasm was completely samutsarita, removed because of tadiya shapa, because of Durvasa's shapa, which came unexpectedly. It was completely unanticipated curse, right? So atarkita upanata, upanata, that which came. Atarkita is not edirbaraama nadandha vishayam. That is, you did not even anticipate such a thing happening, right? So unanticipated curse removed completely his enthusiasm. And then samagrena mandalena nirjihanaha. His entire mandala is the what to say, his luster. That luster was completely gone. Nirjihanaha is actually ha is gat nirgachati. So nirgachan saha raka shashanka iva rahu muke patitaha. The upama here he uses is raka shashankaha is the purna chandra, purnima chandraha iva rahu muke patitaha chandraha iva. During eclipse it's the purnima chandra that the rahu captures, right? So just like how the purnima chandra, when it falls into the mouth of rahu, it loses its entire luster. Samagrena mandalena nirgachanne. So nirjihanaha chandraha iva surapatihi indraha. What did he do? Nagaram agatya. Now how was that nagaram? The rest of the description is only about the nagaram.
Abhitaha prasaryamana vishada mandaksha shabala kataksha sahasra niyamita vyaparam amukhara murajam anahata pataham akwanita veena vaditram avasanna kinnari ganam apravruta rambhadi nrut sanrambham avasita vaitalika loka kolahalam aprasakta vetri hara haharavam anashankita bhata simhanadam astangata anyonya sankatham asambhavita pithamarda vidushaka alapam.
Abhitaha, everywhere prasaryamana vishada mandaksha shabala. Here Indra is so upset and he is also mandaksha. Mandaksha means lajja. Mandaksha, see, the you if you are very bright and happy, the first thing that shows, see, eyes is like the windows to the world, right? So it is windows to the soul. That's what you say. So whatever you're feeling inside, it will immediately be shown in the eye. That's why we also had, when he was showing the anger, he said, koparunam adharayate akshikonam. In the same way here also, the moment we want to know Indra's feeling, it is seen in the eye, which is manda aksha. He is not opening his eyes brightly and showing his happiness. It is sankuchitam. Mandam is slow or it is closed. His eyes are downcast. right? So with downcast eyes means he's very ashamed by his own behavior. So Vishada Mandaksha Prasaryamana. So all his thousand eyes he's not showing directly because of Mandaksha and Vishada, because of Lajja and Dukkham. His Kataksha, he is only showing the corner of his eyes to everybody. So the entire army there, he has controlled their actions because of showing just the corner of his eyes. Why does he show only the corner of his eyes? Because it is, he's feeling ashamed and he's very sad here. So Prasaryamana, he stopped the activity, Niyamita Vyaparam, of with his thousand eyes, Sahasra Kataksha, because he is showing a mixture of Shabala. Shabala means mixture. Mixture of both Vishada, sorrow, and Mandaksha, shame. Which he is, Prasaryamana means he is spreading his eyesight everywhere. He is asking everybody else to stop. So you should remember that entire procession of people that were there. So each one he is going to show how they all stopped their activity. So Niyamita Vyaparam Katham Ityukte Amukhara Muraja. Everything else is how they all stopped their activities. So Muraja is a type of instrument, percussion instrument. Amukhara. Mukharam is sounding or it is noisy. Amukharam is not sounding. So the Muraja was not sounding. These are all going to, as an adjective for the nagaram. Amukharam murajam yasya tat nagara. So for every samasa, every dvitiya vibhakti samasa, you have to take it as qualifying the nagaram. Okay. So anahata pataham. Pataha, it is also another type of percussion instrument. That was not. Ahatam means it is being hit or it is being played upon. Here anahatam, it was not being played upon. So the all the mridanga etc. were just quiet now. Akwanita veena vaditram. There were so many people playing veena. They did not even string it. Akwanitam. Not even one simple sound came from the veena. Veena vaditram. Vaditram is another type of instrument. Or you can also say veena yaha vaditram is, you know, the there are two types in the veena. One is where you play the gamakam, which is the string, that is the top strings. There is another small three strings that are there in the veena, which keeps the thalam. It is called the meet. In Tamil, we say it is the meet that keeps the thalam. That portion is also called the vaditram. Even that meet, when people are not playing, they will at least keep the thalam with that meet, those three strings. Even that did not sound. Akvanita veena vaditram. Avasanna kinnari ganam. Kinnari are the celestial people who sing, right? They also had stopped their ganam music. Apravritta rambadi nritta samrambham. Rambadi, rambha, etc. Their nritta, dance, apravrittam. They did not start it at all. Samrambham is, you know, before they started, they were hitting their legs, you know, just to show the thalam, and they are going to, they were preparing. Arabsyamana. Nrittam, that's what they had described in the Amaravati description. You should remember, sorry, not the Amaravati description. It is the Sena Nasiram, right? The Agrasena description. There they said they were trying to start the Nrityam. That also they did not do. Even the, just the sound of the anklets were also not coming. So Rambhadi Nritta Samrambham Apravrittam. Avasita Vaidalika Loka Kolahalam. Vaidalika are the bards who, Stuti Pataka. They are the people who keep time and tell Indra what is happening at each and every point. So those bards had also stopped their noise. Vaidalika Lokasya Kolahalam api Avasitam Samaptam. Aprasakta Vetri Haharavam. Vetris are those officers who are having those bamboo sticks in their front and they are hitting the ground with the bamboo stick and saying, all of you move, right? That also we saw. If it is like a reflection of how the noise before had completely stopped now, because Indra himself had Niyamita Vyapara with his thousand eyes. Aprasakta Vetri Haharavam. The ha ha, the sound that of ha and ha, that of the vetri, of the officers who are carrying that bamboo sticks, that had also stopped. Aprasaktam, it had not happened. It did not happen. Anashankita bhata simhanadu. I wanted to compare with that old, you know, the other, what is that? Gadhyam. Simhanadam also came there, right? Vaitalika adhikaraha. Parigrihita vaitalika adhikaraha chaturmukaha. And then pakshapata asahishnuta iva parihrita. Where is that? 1 minute. No, the Gadhyam that says, that starts off with sa kadachit asvapno api achara iti bodhitaha vaitalikaha. So each one is a reflection or a virodha to that paragraph. In that, if you see, at the end he will say, sankata unmukta simhanada dharapate nirjagama sankula chalita sena sangha unmukta simhanada dharapate. This entire army was as if it was roaring like a lion. So bhata simhanadam anashankitam. Even a doubt of that roar was not there here, because Indra was feeling so ashamed of his own behavior. Anashankita bhata simhanadam astangata anyonya sankata. People did not stop talking to each other, right? They were all trying to look at Indra, and even that they had stopped. So anyonya sankatha, the conversation between each other, astangatam, it set, all the conversation has stopped. Asambhavita peetamartha vidushaka alapam. This peetamartha and vidushaka are characters who help the nayaka, right? If there is a nayaka in a kavyam, he will have many, there are other upanayakas or small characters. In that you have shata, vita, cheta, peetamardha, vidushaka. These are all types of upanayakas. In that upanayaka category, you will have shata is a type of a villain character. Whereas a peetamardha and vidushaka are helpers to the nayaka. So peetamardha is usually he has most of the qualities of the hero, but he is a little bit lesser than the hero. Kinchid unaha peetamardaha. Whereas Vidushaka is a hasya prayaha. He is also kama sachivaha. That is, he helps the nayaka in all love matters. That is a Vidushaka. So for Indra, of course, Indra has so many nayikas there. Right, we saw the Mugdha Naika, Praudha Naika, Madhya Naika. We saw the description of all those Naikas, right? How he was a Dakshina Naika. So he has to have a Vidushaka to help him out in all this. He also has a Peetamardha. All these people's alapa conversation, asambhavitam, they did not even happen. Where would he have the energy or enthusiasm to do, to engage in such matters? Right? He has to now look at how to regain his strength back. That's why asambhavita peetamardha vidushaka alapam. Next.
Ashvaheshite api satanka sadikulam.
Angri.
Ashvahetishe api satanka sadikulam. Angri vinyasa shabde api. Saparadha sauvidalla janam apanita matanga ghanta valayam.
Stop with that. So now first he described how the people around him were. Next is about the animals that were there. Right? One is those who take care of the animals also. The first is the ashwa or the horses. Ashwa yeshite api satanka sadikulam. See, the animals did what they could, but you cannot stop the activities of the animals that are there. What do they do? Ashwa heshite api, even though the horses were making a sound. Heshitam is the neighing of the horse. The hesharavam is very specific to a horse. Okay, you cannot use that hesha or heshita for any other animal. This so Ashwa Heshita, just like how Garjana is for Simha or Vyagra, it's only for, you can't say Matanga Garjana, you can't say Ashwa Garjana, it's Ashwa Heshita, which is the neighing of a horse. So Ashwa Heshite Api, even though the horses were neighing, Satanka Sadikulam, Sadi Sarathihi. Sarathi Kulam, the entire host of charioteers who were all there managing the horses, they were all Satanka. Satanka means they were apprehensive. They were fearing what we should do. You know, they did not, just because the horse was sounding, they did not, they were trying to keep the horse under control. They were very apprehensive. They were not enthusiastic because of the animal's sound. Satanka Sadikulam, whereas the charioteers were all very apprehensive. Next is the Parijana. Sauvidalla is a Kanchuki. Kanchuki, if you have read many dramas, you will know who a Kanchuki is. He is actually Antapura Charaha, Vriddhaha, Vipraha, Gunaganvitaha, Sarvakaryartha Kushalaha, Kanchuki iti Abhideyate. Kanchuki is usually a guard of the Antapura, the lady's chamber. He is generally an old person. He could be a vipraha, that is a Brahmin, or he could be someone of a very high post in an army who has retired. It's like giving employment to the veterans. It could be that also. He has a lot of good qualities, and that's why he has been appointed as the head of the Antapura Parijana, Sevaka. And he knows, he's very, he's an expert in all sorts of activities. That is a Kanchuki. He's generally known as the guard of the Antapura. That Sauvilla, what is their work? Usually, when there is a king coming in, their work is to go forward and call the king or ask him what is the work that needs to be done and take orders from the king. Here, angri vinyasa shabde api, or when the, you know, the queen comes in or the king comes in, their footsteps are heard. As soon as the footsteps are heard, the Kanchuki is supposed to go forward and ask them. Okay, the angri vinyasa shabde api, angri pada vinyasa pada shabde api. Even when the footsteps were heard, the Sauvidalla Janam, the group of Kanchukis, what did they do? Sabaradhaiva. They were as if they made some mistake and they did not even approach. If someone has made a mistake, if they have made an aparadha, they won't even approach, right? That is how they were. So Sabaradhaiva, in the sense they were apprehensive to approach even the king or the queen, even after hearing their footsteps. So angri vinyasa shabde api, even when footsteps were heard, the Kanchukis were behaving as if they had made some mistake, some big mistake. Saparadha sauvidalla janam. That is how the Kanchukis were in the nagaram. These are all an adjective of the nagara, I told you before, right? Next is apanita matanga ghantavalaya. You cannot make the elephant stop its activity. Have you ever seen an elephant stand still? The elephant will always be moving like this. When we read, when we were young and all, we used to keep the book like this, and to by heart, we would do like this, you know, go for back and forward. My parent mother would say, don't move like an elephant. That is what it means. So when the elephants have the bell around their neck, so when the elephant keeps moving like that, the bell sound will be heard. Whereas Indra wanted all activities to be stopped. So what could they do? They could not stop the elephant from moving. So apanita ganta valaya. They removed the ganta from they removed the bell from the elephants. Next. Abaddhamiva.
Abaddhamiva, mukamiva, badhiramiva, mugdhamiva, prasuptamiva, vikalamiva, shunyamiva, vinyastamiva, chitraphalake, nikhilamapi vibuddha valam, vibuddha balam, akarshan eva kevalam, agatya punaha nagaram, avedya vrittam imam gurave vrittantam, antapuram pravishya, दुरन्तचिन्ता अनुबन्धनियन्त्रितः शयनागारे एव जजागार तां रजनीम्।
So by the time he came to his place, it became night. So you should, I will explain that later. So what happened? Abaddhamiva, it was as if the entire city was as if it was bound. If you just bind someone in their legs and stop them, that was how the whole city was looking at. Mukamiva, it was as if it did not know how to speak. Mukam, like a dumb person. Badiramiva, as if it cannot hear anything. Nobody was making any noise. If they don't make any noise, if the whole world was silent, that is how the world of a person, auditory challenged person would be, right? So badiramiva, mukdamiva, an innocent person also does not get affected by anything. It was as if the entire nagaram was completely innocent and quiet. Mukdamiva or mudaha iva. Mukdaha has two meanings. One is innocent, the other is like an idiot, like a fool. It looked as if it was like a fool. Prasuptamiva, as if it was sleeping. Vikalamiva. Vikalam means handicapped in all ways, physically challenged completely. It cannot move at all. Shunyamiva, as if it was empty. Even though the city was full of people, it sounded or it looked as if it was empty. How was it looking? Chitrapalake vinyastamiva, as if it was drawn on a painting. That was how it was. Nikilamapi vibudabalam, akarshanneva kevalam, nagaram punaha agatya. Surapatihi, Indra, punaha nagaram agatya. He came back to his city again. It was as if he pulled his entire army with him. Nikilamapi vibudabalam, deva senam, Akarshan neva kevalam. It was as if he was dragging the sena along with him. They could not move. It was only because Indra was pulling them or dragging them that they came. So that has an implication on how he left his Amaravati as soon as he finished his Sandhyavandana. And he went to Ganga Tiram to perform the puja for Shiva. After he performed the puja, it can't be 6 hours, right? It can't be night time by then. So probably the Shapa interval would have been only maybe 1 hour. That's all. He would have started off on his procession and he would have met Durvasa, and Durvasa would have, this entire thing must have happened within 5 minutes. He must have given the mala and the mala would have been crushed and he would have given the Shapa. Done. After that, they could not move at all. And Indra had to forcibly, it was as if he was dragging them all back to the city. So by the time, when you're enthusiastic and you want to go, you will always go fast. When you don't want to go for something, you'll drag your feet and come, right? So they took a long time to come to the nagaram. Punaha nagaram agatya. After he came, he immediately went to his guru and said everything. Like a child who has a fight somewhere outside, the moment he enters the house, he will come with his face down, downcast eyes, and come and tell everything to the mother or father, right? Whoever is there at home at that point of time. What happened? That is the one thing that the mother will ask. That's it. Just say everything. Avedya imam vritta, sorry, avedya imam vrittam vrittantam gurave. Vrittam imam vrittantam. Vrittantam is story. Vrittam is that which had happened. Imam, the story that had happened, he said everything to his guru. Gurave avedya. He told his guru. And then what happened? Antapuram pravishya, entered his antapura. Duranta chinta anubandha niyantritaha. Duranta chinta anubandha niyantritaha. Niyantritaha, he was shayanagare eva niyantritaha. He completely kept himself inside the bedroom. Shayanagare, in the bedroom, it was as if he bound himself with the duranta chinta anubandham. Anubandham is in the todarchi, continuous chinta, continuous thoughts which were endless. Duranta, it was completely endless, and he was constantly thinking about what had happened, why it had happened. Duranta chinta anubandha. Anubandha is the shrinkhala, endless worry. With the endless worry, he spent his entire night, tam rajanim, that night, jajagara, jagrit avasthayam, he spent the entire night. He did not sleep. He was constantly thinking about what had happened. Right? Because he was so upset, and he was also ashamed by the way he had behaved. Okay? We'll stop with this. Any doubts? Everybody will be silent now.
பின்னாடி வந்து நல்லது வரும்னு சொல்றதுக்காகவா
இல்ல இல்ல I don't understand why.
So datta bhuvanathankahan sollito bhuvanathukku ittana oru kashtam kudukum sollito ana shankararudaya related அப்படின்ற மாதிரி அந்த வார்த்தை யூஸ் பண்ணிருக்காரு. சோ வந்து
கரோதி இது சங்கரஹ மங்களம் கரோதி இது அப்படிங்கிறது
வைஷ்ணவி புவனாதங்க அந்த மாதிரி.
Even though he gives a suffering to the entire world, he still does an auspicious thing அங்கிறதுக்காக. Not necessary, but it here he actually says சங்கரஸ்ய இதம் சங்கரஹங்கிறச்சு நம்பர் ஒன் ஜஸ்ட் இஸ் ஹவு ஹி இஸ் தி அவதார ஆஃப் த கோப of Shiva, he also can make enna solradhu sham karoti itingra aspect yum highlight pandra maadhiri irukalam, right? That's true. He is also capable of providing auspicious things for the people who have who are the recipient of his curse. So you can say that.
சோ சாபமும் கொடுக்கலாம் விமோச்சனமும் கொடுக்கலாம் அந்த மாதிரி கடைசியில கோவிந்த ஏவ ஏதோ சொல்ற
கோவிந்த ஏவ குஷலானி கரிஷ்யதி அப்படின்னு இல்லையா. சோ ஹி இஸ் கேபபிள் ஆஃப் டூயிங் போத் அண்ட் த ஹைலைட் ஆஃப் ஷோயிங் தட் ஹி இஸ் அன் அவதார ஆஃப் சங்கரா இஸ் வெரி வெரி பியூட்டிஃபுல் ஹியர் பிகாஸ் ஹி சங்கரா இஸ் தி ஹீரோ ஆஃப் த ஹோல் காவியம் இல்லையா. நோவேர் இஃப் யூ சி வேர் துர்வாசா இஸ் பீங் மென்ஷன்ட் very rare that he is highlighted as the avatara of Shiva. If you look at Shakuntalam, he does not highlight him as the avatara of Shiva. It is there somewhere in the Puranas, maybe in
Brahmanda. Unless Shiva Dushanartham. Ambarisha Purana.
In Ambarisha. There you can probably highlight that he is Shiva's avatara. But here he wants to show that it is Shiva's avatara.
ஊனமே இல்ல கிஞ்சி தூனமே இல்ல அதே
இந்திரா இஸ் மோர் ஆஃப் த நாயக்கா சோ இட் பி whether Bindra is the Nayaka or Shiva is the Nayaka, we will know only when we have read the entire text. So at any point, if you are discussing whether he is a Nayaka or a Pitamardha, you have to look at the entire work, Kavyam, to understand whether it is a Pitamardha or a Nayaka. For example, if a Natakam, like just as how I said, you know, if Hanuman natakama irundadna, if Hanuman is the hero there, Rama is not kinchid unaha actually there. Rama is an upanayaka there. You can't call him as Pitamardha there. Yeah, maybe if Rama is the hero of a nataka like Mahavira Charitam, you can say Parashurama is Pitamardha, where he has most of the qualities of Rama. He is an avatara of Vishnu. But he has that anger which is a little bit higher. He has a little bit of pride there where he thinks he is the best Kshatriya. And that's why his going to Swarga was stopped and he became a Chiranjeevi. So you can call him as a Pitamardha there. Kinchid unaha ityukte qualities la unakku vandu koncham koravu irukku. He is not as great. If you look at the Nayaka Guna, Mahakulinata, Aujvalyam, all of these qualities will be there. But there will be something that is a little bit less than the principal Nayaka, principal hero. That is a Pitamarta. Yeah. Okay.